after you released the blocking tutorial for Kiyota, my monkey sitting on the floor and crying. I used all my resources to train him up.
Okay, my bad, my bad. So today I'm going to reveal all of his secrets. And you will be the next Monkey King, yeah. How many of his attack modes?
Let me guess. I think got 4. First is normal dunk with right hand and left hand. Second one is layout, first and second point. And third one is step back and shoot. Spin left or spin right. And the last one is leap dunk.
Yes, these are the basic 4 we must learn.
First is first dunk. Without any talent added, Monkey will only use his right hand, no matter how you spin. And with this talent added, after dribble we can switch to left hand. I am able to do it sometimes only, but I'm not sure how I did.
I have stated the skills by numbers, so we can catch up easily. In order to use left hand fast dunk, you need to move your left analog to the left before doing any dribble move. After you see your hand is dribbling with your left hand, then use your dribble skill one time. Then use your fast dunk, main, left analog, then 3, then 1. If you suddenly stop and move around, it will change back to right down. Bear it in mind.
So the concept is, we must not move anymore after we did the crossover, so we can do the left down smoothly. Even we stop for a while, also will feel the left hand down. Mean, if opponent bump into you and we are being stopped, any fast down will use monkey right hand.
Next is his layup right. Till now, I'm still using his first layout only. I don't know which button to be pressed.
First, remember this. Ask for passing. Then when your body moves forward, then immediately press S. Mean the combo is 2. When see the body move, then S.
Like this? After receiving the ball, I'm keep pressing the S.
But I feel so sore to my finger. Do you have any tips?
Seriously, you're such a lazy guy. Luckily, you are same to me. Just hold the S will do. It has the same effect.
Normally, this layup skill is very useful when the possession is just reset. You're quickly asking for the ball and doing a second point layup. Most likely, only center can react on time, and the on-ball defender will be stunned for a while.
Good sneaky picky skill.
Good one, sensei.
Next is his step back and shoot. After I learned that spin move, the blocker keep coming to me. I feel so sad about it.
First, we need to know the combo first. Pull away left analog, then press 3, then S. If want to spin, then press one more S.
Master, even I'm not pulling away the left analog, I also can do the same move. I don't want to laugh at you.
Still want to laugh at other players. Now I am revealing another secret. Only in Apui Gaming channel. Don't tell anyone. First, it also related to the dribble hand. If your dribble hand is left, Monkey will spin to the right. If your dribble hand is to the right, then... and Monkey will spin to the left. Am I right? Yes.
This is a great move while you're seeing the combo defender stand at the paint area like a stone. Then you can do a step back. Be careful of the distance. Do not step beyond the 3-point line.
If not, your teammate will not pass the bubble to you again. Then no good, no good. Last basic for monkey is the hardest one. This one I need to teach you hand by hand. Let's start. Here is the effective area for leap poster dunk.
Why so small one?
What you just said just now? Small.
Ouch. I mean that area is much smaller than fast dunk zone.
You must say properly, if not I'm going to slam you like the bobo.
My bad.
So long after you leap forward, still standing within the effective area, then you can make it. Here is the best spot. We still can use one finger to control. Like this. The control button is 3-2. If you fail, it will be coming passing or a layup. This is the quite manageable distance. When you see the ball was going to pass up, the moment then press 3 and 2 in a very fast speed, then it will be a successful one.
For the distance shorter than this, most likely one finger style cannot make it because we need much faster reaction speed to click 2 buttons, which is unlikely to happen. During the match, even harder to press at the correct timing when we are panicking. No matter how fast the finger press, still unable to keep up the speed and keep passing back to his teammates.
If you really want to be very good, then can react even in shorter time, then we should use two fingers. For me, I will use thumb to hold the phone as support, then use middle finger for skill 3, and index finger to press skill 2. I press the button almost at the same time. If you really want to do this close distance lip dunk, we must master it. My suggestion is very simple. Don't do a lip dunk in such a close distance, easily making mistake. No good, no good.
Master, it is still too hard for me. My agility is not as good as you. How? Please save me.
Okay, the last trick is wall hitting lip dunk. This is even slower. When you see the ball is approaching you at the last moment, then do a lip dunk. Since the passing speed is the slower than those close distance pass, it allows us to have more time to react.
Wow, that is amazing. Thanks a lot, Master.
Now is the tip for free training camp. If your pass is failed, the ball will be bounced very far away. Then we should summon our ball boy. Turns on the rifle option. He will help us to pick up the ball. Then we close it back.
Magic. Then the bubble is on our head.
の誇りや夢 全部やる
I pass all my knowledge to you. Like Zack passed his dream to Cloud. Please, continue my dream. Haha, just kidding. If you enjoy the content, please give me a like and subscribe my channel. I will be back.